this world. Get your baby within. Watch that little girl. Her daddy drank all day. Mommy did drugs. Never wanted to play. Only kisses and hugs. She'd watch the TV and sit there on the couch while her mom fell asleep and her daddy. Behind their couch, she'd be Eileen. Oh, what a sad little night.
Yeah, I recognize you. You're Red Allen, some of you Red Allen's boys, aren't you? Huh?
Yeah.
Yeah, that's what I thought. Ladies and gentlemen, here they are, the Allen Brothers.
Yeah.
People would come from far away and dance on after the break of day. Hollywood hollered, oh, she dog, and he walked in, was ready to go.
Late in the evening, about sundown, how he looked up out of town. Uncle Pimp played fiddle, Lord, how it rained, he could have talk, he could have sing.
You know, some people just don't need it. I mean, I'll admit it, I need it every now and then. Because I just have trouble getting out of damn bed. But you need it too. In fact, you could use some right now. You're starting to press the hell out of me just looking at you. Anybody have any questions?
You
enter a quest? Anything? No, we don't take quests. What the hell? I brought a set list. I mean, come on. I wrote a song about about being the baby of the family, which I am, and I noticed years later that a lot of people in show business just happen to be the babies of their family, and which made a lot of sense to me, you know, because you kind of grow up with that look at me attitude and trying to get attention all the time, and so you end up getting on stage to get attention, maybe, and you end up drinking to get attention. That's what I told Debbie, it's the reason I drank. Going to massage parlors for attention. Well, I might be pushing it here, but anyway, now I am depressed. Anyway, but what was cool about after I wrote it, I used my brother's real names in the song, which is something they rarely did in life. But he didn't change that in the song, and you know, it ended up just pissing them off because it got to be a big hit, and they, you know, all their buddies going, "Hey, where'd you name that song?" and stuff. Anyway, it goes something like, well, it's going to be pretty much like this. So. I'm so over this. Why don't we all just go to the bar and have a shot? Anyway, it goes something, well, it's pretty much. I used to be I worked at this place where I was stacking cokes. I was well referred to as a coke stacker. And I did that for about 3 months in Cincinnati, Ohio. And something about it, I just didn't like being called a coke stacker. I'm not sure why. So I left that job and got a job in a sock place as a sock tucker. And after a couple months, that started to bother me. And I heard about a new job, and it was at a wine orchard, and I went there and found out I was going to be a corkscrewer, and I went to hell with it. I'm going to Nashville. Anyway. Y'all remember this kickoff? I probably didn't have to do it again, did I? Here's an old, one of Lester Earl's old songs. It's called On My Mind. Well, I can't eat and I can't sleep. All I do is sit and cry. And listen for your footsteps at my door. Keep it.
asking myself why we ever said goodbye. Or I guess I'd shed a million tears or more.
First day of Sunday school, the preacher walked in, and a small little girl stared at a picture of him. She said, I know that man up there on that cross. I don't know his name, but I know him. I hear